गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट पी ब्लॉक एलिमेंट्स एंड इन पी ब्लॉक एलिमेंट्स सो फार वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट प्रिपरेशन ऑफ डाइऑक्सीजन, प्रिपरेशन ऑफ ओजोन, प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ ओजोन, प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ ऑक्सीजन. यू नो दैट फॉर्म्स मेटालिक एंड नॉन मेटालिक ऑक्साइड्स एंड अ फ्यू एम्फोटेरिक ऑक्साइड्स. वी हैव सीन प्रिपरेशन ऑफ सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड एंड वी हैव सीन हाउ O3 कैन बी एस्टिमेटेड क्वांटिटेटिवली. All right. This was what we had seen in group 16. All right. And before that, we had discussion about group 15 in detail. Today, we'll be seeing the oxo acids of sulfur and their structure. Their preparation is not there, so we'll have to only see the structure. Oxo acids of sulfur. The commonly known sulfuric acid to all of us is sulfurous acid. Simple one. H2SO3. Now, what is its structure? Since it has two basic OH group, means its basicity is 2. So it has polarity, one double bond oxygen and one lone pair will be there. Its basicity is 2 because it has 2 replaceable H plus ions. It has two replaceable H plus ions. Next is H2SO4. With this lone pair of electron, another oxygen can form bond. And these two will remain same. How? Like this. Sulfur lone pair was there, oxygen will come. And this bond will be formed. Its basicity will also be equal to. Let us pause and discuss a little bit more about it. Here you will see that it has discrepancy of one oxygen. It has all its oxygen there. All its six valencies is fulfilled. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But here, this lone pair of electron still can form a bond pair and it can take one oxygen. So H2S2O3 can act as a reducing agent because it can take one oxygen. It can still take one oxygen, so it can act as a reducing agent. But H2SO4 can act as a good not oxidizing agent, we write dehydrating agent. Since H2SO4 is a good dehydrating agent, so it is used for charring of sugar. So if you put any carbohydrate in H2SO4, concentrated H2SO4, so it takes out the H plus and OH minus ion and the water comes out. When water comes out, then only carbon is left and the black colored char is seen. It is called as charring of hydrocarbon derivative. So any organic compound, if it is treated with sulfuric acid, then either it catches fire if it is inflammable due to heat, or it undergoes charring due to evolution of H2O molecule or condensation of H2O molecule. So the molecule can undergo condensation, H2O molecules can come out. It is such kind of dehydrating agent that if two H2SO4 molecules are kept together and are heated, it can itself give out H2O molecule out. Okay, so we'll see how. With that, we will be able to understand another oxo acids of sulfur. Hope these two are clear and it is there in the frame of the camera. Yes. Nowadays I have learnt how to make good videos, you know. I have learnt it from many online teachers. Like I have learnt a few from An Academy. I have learnt a few from Alakh Pandey sir. I have learnt a little bit from evidyarthi.in, Mansi madam. So they are the good, you know, online teachers. So I was following them how they do. So they always say that the light, sound, camera, action should be good. So slowly I could make it good. And that is why my views are increasing and you are taking interest. Thank you for that. Otherwise, if I make a video which is not visible, if the voice is not good, if light is not good, why will you see? I understand that. Earlier, See, these things we were not knowing, okay, but now we have learned it. So that is why we are improving. Okay, so thank you for bearing with us. So next is H2SO4. There is no harm in learning from anyone. If two H2SO4 molecules like this if COVID-19 would not had been there, we would not have been able to learn so much. We would only have taught students in the classroom conventionally. If you heat it, then OH molecule of one and H plus molecule of the another comes out. C minus H2O. So it undergoes dehydration. It takes place when you heat it. So what will happen if we form? Yes, it is still visible. So what is it? It is H2 plus H2SO4. We have heated it. H2 has come out. Now what is formed? H2O, how many? 7. It is also called as oleum because it is as dense as oil. Just like oil, okay. Or you can also write it as H2SO4 dot SO3, which is also called as fuming sulfuric acid. Since we are heating it, and hence it is formed, so we also call it as pyrosulfuric acid. So in these three ways we name it: fuming sulfuric acid, oleum, or pyrosulfuric acid. Okay, next is peroxosulfuric acid. So what, how it is formed? First of all, a peroxide linkage will be there. This is a peroxide linkage. Now connect it with sulfur, connect it with sulfur. Now six bonds has to be satisfied. One bond is already there. One bond with double bond oxygen. 1, 2, 3 is done. Then 1, 2, 3. And one more, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and one more, which this side. So it is called as peroxo sulfuric acid. Since two sulfuric acids are there, two units are there, means if you give water, it can break from here, isn't it? So we will put one more prefix, peroxo disulfuric acid. Peroxo disulfuric acid. So this was all about structure of the oxo acids of sulfur. Now we will see how sulfuric acid is manufactured. Okay. So I'll make a separate video of that so that I can upload it quickly.